All right, let's kick it, shall we?
Let's do it.
Hello, Kenny.
Good morning, Christy. Good morning, Wayne. You guys are going to love this. Love with Christy. I know Duke is my boy, you know, so you can bring all the kids over, because I always have to say Duke at least once a week, because he's my buddy. All right, we're at the Great Lakes Science Center. Now, if you guys remember, if you're wondering where the permanent exhibit was, Scott, there was an amphitheater that went down.
There was an amphitheater that went down, and we have put a whole new floor in this exhibit. We've invested about $5 million in the entire space to unveil the Cleveland Creates Gallery.
And then what's really cool is we're seeing this up here, but beneath, you guys expanded the robotics program.
We did. So we have a robotics lab down there. We have the Rockwell Robotics Lab and the TransDigm Learning Center. So we have a classroom and a robotics lab and an all-new 2,500 square foot exhibit space to show
for
it. Love
it. Starting out with this little centerpiece, let's talk about this gym.
So we wanted to start something iconic in Cleveland. Mm-hmm. We're highlighting all of the technology in Cleveland. Why not use the terminal tower that everyone sees and loves? And we talk about Cleveland's dedication to the Internet of Things, which is a nice little part of technology in Northeast Ohio. And to understand that, you want to use sensors. So all around this very cool terminal tower are sensors. You have light sensors, color sensors, metal sensors. You can see the audio sensor right here with the bounce meter. And anybody that comes to the exhibit can actually have the power now to change the lights on the top
of
the terminal
tower. We'll talk about that in a minute. Over here,
you got it.
I see robotics.
We have remote robotics exploration.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
This is where you can either do laparoscopic surgery, you can use a Mars rover, you know, a planet away, where you can actually sit here and use your hands to move something in the distance.
Okay.
What the user over here will be very surprised to see as they start moving these washers around is on the other side, somebody can watch what you're doing. So
no pressure.
It is technically remote, but it's not that far away. And we worked with our friends at the NASA Glenn Research Center, being the home of the NASA Glenn Visitor Center here. They let us know everything we should know about remote robotic exploration.
Well, I'm definitely going to have to work on that.
You're doing
Luckily,
great.
Luckily, we have four more seconds. Okay. Over here, this is really cool and unique.
Yeah,
Let's talk about this.
So Cleveland produces a bunch of products and a bunch of widgets, but the Vitamix blender, we think, you know, is the most recognizable consumer product here. Mm-hmm. But what we really want to show with this view is that it takes a lot of tiny pieces to make. So a lot of folks work in the manufacturing industry here in Northeast Ohio, where maybe they just make screws, or maybe they just make the blade that goes in there, or the nut that goes on the bolt.
But that's important.
That's
because
very
it's part
important.
Of the big picture.
That's exactly right. Not everything that the city makes comes out in a nice consumer package.
Wow.
It takes everyone to build all the little pieces that build these technologies.
It's very important for the students to see where STEM technology can take them, and that's why you guys have this awesome display.
Yep.
Let's talk about this.
We partnered with some of the biggest organizations in Cleveland, SwageLock, Rockwell Automation. Of course, the Sherwin-Williams Company has had our back throughout the whole design of this exhibit. Mm-hmm. And this is where you get to learn about the real people that do the real jobs in Northeast Ohio. So you will see our friends that showed up. They show up here for Manufacturing Day. They show up here for Tech Careers Day.
Okay.
Again, it's not just in this exhibit. This goes on and lives throughout the year at Great Lakes Science Center.
Love it. Okay, well, we're running out of time, but we have so much more to show everybody here. Congratulations.
It's been 2 years in the making.
Yeah, $5 million project, and guess what? It's all ours this morning. All right,
you got
we
it.
Are going to go back to you guys in the studio, because we're going to end with this almost naked guardian, and we'll explain that when we come back.
Oh, I'm sticking around for that. Okay.